This is Allie Acosta, back when she was Alison Perez. Once upon a time, she was a financial controller at Globe Equities, a large insurance firm in Chicago. Then, in early 2011, FBI arrested her for embezzlement, nearly $20 million stolen over 5 years.
Yikes.
According to social media, everyone in Allie's life was shocked. She had always been an incredibly hard worker, a button-up rule follower who'd never even gotten a traffic ticket. Then, in keeping with the seeming shift of character, Allie skipped bail in late 2011 and has been in the wind ever since.
You find any signs she's spending the money? Because she didn't use it on her condo. It's completely paycheck appropriate.
Nothing so far.
Theo's around 11 years old. The timeline makes me think that Allie skipped bail because she was pregnant.
Which begs the question, why would Allie leave town without her son now?
She won't.
Well, good thing the kid's secure here at Pearl.
Except he's not. He's sure there were two men chasing him.
Yeah, and that neither were Mitchell Smith. I showed Theo his photo.
I wonder if they were bounty hunters too.
Doubtful. Theo said that these goons knocked over a kid while they were chasing him. That's a move that could lose a bounty hunter their license.
Okay, let us know what they say. So far, no one at the school got a good look at him, but Kai's checking with security.
All right, I'll call the family advocacy rep, see if they have someone that can come tonight. Best to keep him safe at Pearl until we ID these guys.
Do we think the kidnappers are connected to the bounty hunter?
Smith said he was working alone. I buy it as much as I distrust them. I mean, I think if he had other people working with him, Allie wouldn't have gotten away so easily.
You said your bounty hunter reached out to the bondsman when he got a lead on Allie. Could be someone involved in her original crime bribed the bondsman to get that information.
$20 million's a lot of money. That was no easy theft she pulled off. She might have had partners. And if she double-crossed those partners, then they'd be motivated to find her. Hanging out at Theo's school might have been their only play.
So what do they do next?
I don't know. Knowing who they are will help us figure that out. Lucy, go help Bernie. He's digging into the case that got her arrested 11 years ago.
Yeah, we'll do.
Theo and his mom have been communicating. Jesse, you think you can talk to him?
Yeah, convince him that helping us is better than lying to us.
Please and thank you.
ACH for major bills, credit cards for most other expenses. The only money going into her account are the couple's paychecks.
Well, she stole $20 million. She's doing a really good job of hiding it.
Yeah.
Just like you did with this Agent Afloat assignment.
I wasn't hiding it.
You just didn't tell anybody.
When I applied, I knew y'all would tell me I was being reactive to my breakup with Whistler. And then I didn't get picked, so what did it matter?
Now you got it. How do you feel?
Obviously, the timing's painful. But being a sole NCIS agent on an aircraft carrier, that power and responsibility.
All that fear of falling overboard.
I'd get over that, wouldn't I? I can't tell if that laugh is good or bad. Come on, you gotta have some advice for me.
Yes, when you got together with Whistler, you should have pulled your application.
You know, time travel is your solution to a lot of things.
It's my way of saying it's an unsolvable problem without actually having to say that.
What about the original investigation?
Wow, nice topic bust. She was accused of siphoning money out of small business insurance settlements with the imbalances getting lost on some reconciliation accounts.
Where'd she siphon the money to?
Investigators never found it.
So settlements, that's payables. Imbalances, that's accounting. Reconciliations, that's auditors.
I feel like I'm in that home economics class balancing my checkbook all over again.
You took home ec?
I loved home ec. What's your point?
So Tenet has a hunch that Allie wasn't working alone. She was a low-level controller, and when Global Equities went bankrupt, these three guys started a new company with the same business model.
I'm not following. How is three executives starting a new company a red flag?
Because the new company went bankrupt 2 years ago after $8 million disappeared into tax shelters and bad investments.
Okay, I'm seeing the flag now. Mm-hmm. These three guys may have continued stealing money under a new banner, which means they may have been Allie's accomplices at Globe Equities 11 years ago?
It's possible. Do you think my relationship with Whistler will work if I take the Agent Afloat job?
You know me, I have an opinion about everything. On this, though, I'm gonna take a pass.